The investigation is now concluded into the sexual harassment allegations leveled against Calgary Liberal MP Kent Hehr. But Kent and those Liberals, well, they don't think you need to know what those findings are. Calgary Liberal MP Kent Hehr was accused of sexual harassment by two different women earlier this spring. One woman said that Hehr allegedly touched her inappropriately at an event, and a second woman who worked at the Alberta Legislature during the time when Kent Hehr was an MLA there said he made suggestive comments to her and that she was warned by her colleagues to avoid getting in an elevator with him. So Hehr resigned from the Liberal cabinet, and the Prime Minister's office, at the expense of the taxpayer, hired a lawyer to investigate the women's claims. Let me reiterate that here. The Canadian public paid for this investigation into sexual harassment allegations against a sitting MP in the government's caucus. That's as good a reason as any for the Canadian public to know exactly what are in those documents. But now we're finding out that the government will keep the findings of the investigation a complete and total secret. According to Kent Hehr, the investigation found that he had not acted in an inappropriate fashion with the one woman who said that he had touched her. That contact was determined to be incidental contact, but we'll never really know because the findings will not be publicly released to any of us. We're just supposed to take everyone's word for what the documents say. The explanation for keeping the investigation secret, according to Kent Hehr, well, that's private too. He told CBC Radio, and I quote, "The process in place, it has private information. People have concerns raised, and I think it's a legitimate way for people involved to take place in this. And I think there are legitimate privacy concerns." Whose privacy concerns is Kent Hehr talking about? His? I think so, because one of the women publicly came out and named herself in a series of tweets. Kristen Raworth said she was the one subject to creepy innuendo from Kent Hehr during his time at the Alberta Legislature. And that other woman, the second woman who brought forward allegations of being touched by Hehr at an event, has never been publicly named. Her identity has been successfully protected all along in this process. And it would be very easy to just redact her name from the investigation's findings so that the public can know exactly what the investigation found or hasn't found that Kent Hehr has done to the women who work around him. That's exactly what was done for another Liberal MP's accusers. The names of the women involved in the sexual misconduct investigation into Darshan Kang were redacted. Their identities were protected. It can be done. It has been done successfully, and pretty recently at that. The Liberals of the Me Too movement seem pretty darn happy to protect their own by sealing records, while also simultaneously claiming that women need to be believed and that they need to come forward and that transparency is an important thing in all of this. Liberals keep saying that if women come forward and tell their stories, that hearts and attitudes will change about harassment in the workplace. But here, women have come forward and told their stories, but no one will ever hear their stories because the Liberals are sealing the records to protect their own. Liberals can't have it both ways. Liberals can either think that sunlight is the best disinfectant, like I do, or they can go out of their way to seal investigations that the public has paid for to protect powerful men from the women they have been accused of harassing. All we know right now is that the report found that Hehr did make Raworth feel uncomfortable and that Kent Hehr has apologized for that. But that's all we really know for sure about the contents of the report. Oh, and we also know that Kent Hehr has announced that he will seek re-election in his Calgary riding. So it looks like the Liberal Party is sealing these records that you paid for to protect Kent Hehr from the political fallout in 2019. For the Rebel.media, I'm Sheila Gunn-Reid. Like I just said in my daily video, I firmly believe that sunlight is the best disinfectant, and that is why I wrote an expose on David Suzuki. It's called The Case Against David Suzuki, an unauthorized biography, and you can download your copy for free today at suzukibook.com. And if you want to help cover the cost of producing this book, you can donate there too at suzukibook.com.